Very good morning to all my dear friends, my dear students and the viewers. I am Professor Ashwadeep Fuljale, Assistant Professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering at Tulsiram G. Gaikwad Patel College of Engineering and Technology, Wardha Road, Nagpur. The institute is NAC A plus accredited by National Assessment and Accreditation Council, Bangalore. I welcome you all for the today's demonstration session and the hands-on session on to the lathe machine. Before proceeding towards anything, today I am blessed with the kind presence of my colleague who will be associating me for the today's demonstration and the instructor Mr. Chitrasen Gajbir sir and Mr. Vishal sir. My dear friends, as far as the curriculum of mechanical engineering second year is concerned, the second year mechanical engineering is having one compulsory subject, machining process. That machining process deals with all the machines who are used in the industries for the machining purpose. My dear friends, here I mean machining is the use of machine which implements their energy to remove the material from the surface of the workpiece. That is what the definition of machining is. I am standing into the centralized workshop of the institute wherein you can see several machines are there. The institute's workshop is equipped with the lathe machine and all the necessary machines which are essentially required as far as the curriculum of mechanical engineering is concerned. Right. Now, I am standing beneath a lathe machine. As you can see, very adjacent to me is a lathe machine. This is the most popularly used machine in the industry, and it is also called as the universal machine. Why? Because we can perform several machining operations onto the lathe machine. This particular type of lathe machine is a cone and pulley driven mechanism lathe machine, and the demonstration part is concerned, we will be talking about all the major parts of the lathe machine. Now let us move on to the basic parts of the lathe machine. Now this particular type of lathe machine, as you can see into the workshop, the major part of this machine is a headstock. As you can see on to the right hand side of mine is the headstock. The headstock is associated with the gear train and cone and pulley driven mechanism that helps to drive the spindle. The spindle is a main part wherein the workpiece is mounted. This headstock not only gives the energy for the rotation of the spindle, but also it is also engaged with the reverse feed mechanism which is implemented in the thread cutting operation. This portion onto this side, you can see it is the headstock. The reverse feed mechanism pulley is associated, and that portion is connected to the lead screw. The lead screw will play a vital role in the lathe machine that we will be discussing later on. The other end of lathe machine is consist of a tailstock. That tailstock, this portion is particularly called as the tailstock, wherein a clamping lever is there and the feed wheel is also there. The main purpose of the tailstock is to mount the drilling and associated tools, wherein that can be utilized to perform drilling, boring and associated operations that we are going to discuss in today's presentation. My dear friends, as we were discussing about, it is a universal machine. Why? Because apart from facing turning, step turning, taper turning. We can perform thread cutting operation also. And thread cutting operation, as we all are aware, that it is very crucial part of the machining process that can be beautifully performed with the help of lathe machine. Apart from those machine, we can perform knurling with the help of a specified tool. A knurling tool is there. Apart from that, chamfering can be performed with the implementation and use of tailstock. We can perform drilling, boring, counter boring, counter sinking, and tapping operation. My dear friends, tapping operation is used to perform internal thread cutting operation. Right, that was the utilization of the tailstock. The tailstock is mounted onto the guide ways. That guide ways will guide the tailstock towards the spindle that will be utilized for perform drilling and associated operation. Apart from that, taper turning is one of the crucial operation that can be performed. With the tailstock offset mechanism, we can perform the taper turning operation. Right, this is the spindle. The spindle is associated with the three jaw chuck. Here on your screen you can see the three jaw chuck, my dear friend. Apart from three jaw chuck, we can use the four jaw chuck. Here you can see the key slot is there. With the help of this key, we can tighten or we can loose the chuck, and wherein we will be mounting our cylindrical workpiece. Right. Mainly we are mounting the cylindrical workpiece. As far as the theoretical portion is concerned, several accessories and attachments are there that can be used to mount versatile dimension objects rather than cylindrical one. Right. Now moving to the centralized portion of this lathe machine, here you can see a massive part wherein several components are there. This is the most important part of this lathe machine. It is a carriage. As far as title is concerned, this carriage carries five important parts. That carriage, as you can see, is mounted along with the guide ways and the lead screw. The lead screw is having square thread. The square thread, as we all know, that the square thread is used to transmit maximum power, right? This carriage, apart from that, it carries five important things, like it is the apron part, this is the saddle one, this is the compound rest. Okay, this is the carriage. This carriage consists of apron, then saddle, this cross slide, compound rest, and the tool post. As far as title is concerned, the tool post is the place wherein we mount our single point cutting tool. My dear friends, in the theoretical part of this subject, we have good discussion over the single point cutting tool. The single point cutting tool, that it means while performing the machining operation, a single cutting edge participates in the material removal. That is why it is called as single point cutting tool. Whereas multi point cutting tool is the tool which utilizes two or more than two cutting edges for the material removal. As far as the geometry is concerned, we can achieve several objects with the help of this machine. Right. I'll tell you once again, this is the tool post wherein we are going to mount the tool. This is the single point cutting tool we are mainly using onto the lathe machine. This part is the compound rest. This one is the cross slide. I will show you the movement. This is the cross slide. Why it is called as the cross slide? Because if we look onto the workpiece an imaginary line passing through the center of this workpiece we usually call as the axis. The movement of this cross slide is in perpendicular direction. That is why it is called as cross slide. Whereas compound rest, this particular portion is called compound rest, and wherein you can observe the calibrations are there. Those calibrations are utilized to perform taper turning operation. We will be discussing more about that particular operation in the coming session, right? So the tool post, compound rest, cross slide, apron and the saddle, these five parts are associated with the carriage. As you can see, several levers are there, and the wheels, those wheels are utilized to give the movement to the tool. Now, what types of movement that can be given to the tool? The tool can be given linear motion, longitudinal motion, as well as if we make some arrangement onto the compound rest, we can give angular motion also. That angular motion is utilized to perform the taper turning operation, right? Now, we will move on to the actual demonstration. I am going to start this machine and I will show you how the machining is performed onto the workpiece. Generally, a cylindrical workpiece is mounted onto the three jaw chuck. As you can see here, one cylindrical workpiece is mounted. Before proceeding towards actual machining operation, we will have to cross check the center of tool, that is the tip of the tool is onto the live center. The live center is the central part of this workpiece. As we have discussed, central part and imaginary line passing through it is nothing but the axis, right? As we can see, the center is matched here. Now we can perform the machining operation, right? For machining, we will require the rotation of spindle in anti-clockwise direction. As you can see here, anti-clockwise rotation of spindle is required. Right. Firstly, we will be performing the facing operation. For facing operation, my dear friends, we give feed to the cutting tool. You will have to perform very consciously, and we must follow all the safety measures for performing those operations. Material is removed in the form of chips. The theoretical portion discuss about the types of chips also, wherein you will find one compulsory question in the examination. Thank you. once again, we must follow all the safety instructions before performing the machining operation. And in the sequence of same, I have secured my ID badge also. Now you can see and observe a smooth surface is achieved. This is what the facing operation is. Right. And this part is nothing but the chip. As you can see, the theoretical portion deals about the different types of chips that can come out as the remedial part of this machining. There are three types of chips, like continuous chips, discontinuous chips, and the continuous chips with the built-up edges. Right. Now I will be performing the turning operation. Firstly, we perform facing, then we will be performing the turning operation. Right. For the turning operation, I will have to make changes over the tool post. You will have to change the angle of cutting edge as per as the axis of workpiece is concerned. Okay.